talk about? Before we start?
So fine.
Okay, that's
Fine,
okay.
sir.
Okay, Krishna, are you there? Krishna? Mr. Krishna?
Yes,
Right. So I hope that when the session starts, you three will be keeping your video on so that students can have good time interacting with you all, right? Will it be like that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, that's fine.
Yes.
Right.
Many students have joined. I think I am audible. Morning, students.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Thank you. Thank you. So in a very short while, we are going to start our webinar on IIT and JEE preparations tips by our IITians and NITians. You can see on your screen, we have three resource person for today's webinar. Mr. Krishna Prakash, Mr. Karan Gupta, and Rahul Agarwal. All three are in the reputed IITs. You can see on your screen. And the students, those who have joined from Disley Vidyalaya, if you are having any problem in joining, the YouTube link is shared with you all. So you can directly join the session on this topic through our YouTube channel also. During the interaction session, during the webinar, I would request all the students to keep their cameras on so that it will be very friendly way to interact with our resource person. Yes, all the students, those who have joined, I request you all to turn on your cameras. All the students, those who have joined, I think I'm audible to you all. You can just turn on your camera. I can see many students have joined with us. Very good. Yes, good morning, everyone. Once again, those who have joined us through the YouTube channel, good morning, everyone. Welcome to the meet. In a very short while, we are going to start our webinar. During the meet, if you have any question you want to ask to our resource person, you can directly use the chat box option. We will pick up the questions from there also. And those viewers, those students who have joined with us through our YouTube channel, from there also will pick up the questions. You can, in the comment box, you can type your questions, and with the help of our resource person, we'll get back with the answers of your questions. You will send to us through Zoom Meet or through YouTube channel. So I can see on my screen many students, those who have joined. Still many of you have not turned on your camera. So I'll again request all the students to turn on the camera. I can see on my screen Shubham, Srishti, Sasi Sharma, Archie Kapsime, Anuj, Arshraj Singh, Aryan, Aditi, Shreya, Abhijit Kumar, Harsh, Anuj, Aryan, turn on your cameras.
Abhijit, Mr. Abhijit.
Yes, sir.
Can we put a request in the comment box of YouTube link, okay, that students who are there with YouTube, they can directly join us with Zoom also, so that they can have face-to-face interaction with all the three resource persons, right?
Right, sir.
So, like, I can see that there are around 20 odd students there with YouTube link. They have logged in. So, we can make a request to them to come with Zoom link, because we have the space available here for them, right?
Okay, sir.
In comment box of YouTube link, you can mention this.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Abhijit, are you there?
Yes, sir.
In a short while, we'll be starting with the session. I hope that we can wait for another 2 to 3 minutes and
right,
we can proceed further with the session.
Right, sir. So all the students, those who have joined with us, once again, we are requesting you all, during the session, you can just keep your cameras on, those who have joined with us through the Zoom meet. If you have any questions regarding the webinar, you can use the chat box option. We'll pick up the questions directly from the chat box. And those viewers watching us live on the YouTube, in the comment section, you can put up your questions. I will pick up the questions from there also. Students, those who have joined on YouTube, if you wish to join, we have space available in Zoom. You can come and join in Zoom also. In a very short while, we are going to start our webinar.
Yes, Mr. Abhijit, I think now we are ready to start with the session.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Abhijit, are you there? Right. Okay. So now you can proceed further with your proceedings, right? So before you proceed further, you can take confirmation from all the three resource persons, Mr. Krishna, Mr. Karan, and Mr. Rahul Agarwal, that they are ready to proceed further, and then you can start with your opening formality. Yes,
sir.
Abhijit,
sir.
Right now.
Thank you, sir. And I think our resource person, Mr. Krishna Prakash, Mr. Karan Gupta, and Mr. Rahul Agarwal, all three of them are available with us. They have joined with us.
Yes,
so can we start the session now?
Sure, sir.
Okay, so we have few opening formalities. So very warm good morning to one and all present in the Zoom meet, our respected CEO, sir, Prakash Gupta, sir, coordinators, teachers, my dear students and the viewers joined with us through the YouTube channel. today. It's a very golden chance for the students of Grizzly Vidyalaya to know how to prepare for the IIT JEE preparations. Students, before starting the session, I'll just introduce to our resource persons. So first we have Mr. Rahul Agarwal. He's from Hazaribagh and currently studying computer science and engineering in IIT ISM Dhanbad. He has completed his 12th from St. Columbus College, Hazaribagh. Next we have Mr. Krishna Prakash. He is from Hazaribagh too and currently studying architecture and regional planning in IIT Kharagpur. Completed his 12th from Sanjeev School, Hazaribagh. You can see on your screen. And the third resource person for today's webinar is Mr. Karan Gupta. He is from Hazaribagh and currently studying electrical engineering in NIT Raurkela. Completed his 12th from DAV Hazaribagh as a topper with 96.2% and standard 10th from Holy Cross School Hazaribagh as a topper with 96.2%. So these are the resource person for today's webinar. So now, with the permission of all the three resource person, we can
Abhijit, I would like to take the mic from you and I'd like to speak a few sentences for my students before you hand over the proceedings to all the three resource persons. Anyway, very, very good morning to everyone present in this session. And in fact, this session has been planned with a very clear purpose of getting information regarding the preparation of IIT JEE, as it has been told to all of you. Friends, we all must know the fact that we all want to go ahead in our life, and for that we need to get ideas, we need to get guidelines from the people who really deserve to guide us to proceed further in our life. In fact, it is said that it is better to read a man than to read 100 books. What does it mean exactly? It means that if you think of preparing for IIT JEE and you take the help of many of the books as well, you go for many of the classes from the teachers as well, and then that certainly helps you in getting success in those examinations to a greater extent. But then as this session has been planned, keeping the same in mind that if you interact with these resource persons who have recently qualified for these premier institutions and they are there with you to have to share their experience of making preparations for these all entrance examinations, and how could they make it? The most coveted question, the punchline, the million dollar question is that how could they make it? Was it really a miracle for them, or was it a cakewalk for them? Today the session will definitely let you all know that whether it has been a miracle for them, or it has been a cakewalk for them, or it has been there with them because they really use the right way to prepare for the examination. Well, when you study, when you pursue your course for class 11 and 12, you have the target of performing better in a board examination. But then at the same time, when you think of appearing in this entrance examination, basically interacting with the students of class 12, in the past also I have often felt that they are on the crossroads. They often feel that if they start preparing for IIT JEE exams, their board results will be affected. This is one point that they often have in their mind, and that is why they say that no, right now they want to go for the preparation of board examinations mainly, and later they will think of IIT JEE exams. Is it like that? Can't we prepare? Can't we develop our skills to focus on the preparation of IIT JEE simultaneously? These are the questions which these all three resource persons who are present here with us will be able to answer of yours. And we hope that when the session comes to an end, you will be able to overcome many of the confusions which you have with them regarding the preparation of the examination. With this, I conclude my words, and all the best for everyone for a very fruitful session. To make this session interesting, you all are requested to make it interactive whenever the chance is given. The students are requested to come forward and put forward the questions to the resource sponsors after their presentation is over. That's all from my side, Abhijit. Now it's over to you to proceed to hand it over to our resource person. Yes, Abhi.
Thank you, sir, for your motivational words for our students. So now I request our resource persons to take over the proceedings from here.
Okay, the request goes to first Mr. Rahul Agrawal.
Okay, sir. So we request Mr. Rahul Agrawal, sir, now.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Rahul Agrawal. Currently, I am pursuing Bachelor of Technology in Computer Science and Engineering at IIT ISM Dhanbad. I have just completed my first year. I have cleared GE Advanced as an appearing candidate in 2020. My rank was, CRL rank was 5,682 and OBC and CL, that is category rank was 962. I had taken guidance from Achievers classes at Dhanbad. I am here to share my experience and give you some insights about nature and preparation of JE Advanced and JE Mains examinations. Let's first discuss about JE Mains exam, because first you have to pass JE Mains to sit into the examination of JE Advanced, right? So for JE Mains, you have to cover whole syllabus. That is, you can't afford to skip any chapter, right? JE Mains syllabus has a little bit extension of JE Advanced syllabus, right? So it has little big syllabus, but questions are asked from approximately every chapter and each section, right? So and the most important thing about JE Mains is that you can't leave NCERT. This is your plus point, that you are a school going student. So you are studying NCERT in the class. So you don't have to study too much from your side. So yes, so try to benefit this plus point of yours, and don't leave NCERT, right? Especially for physics and chemistry. In chemistry, you will see that approximately more than 50% questions are directly from the lines of NCERT. For JE Mains, I am telling you, right? Syllabus is, whole syllabus covering is very, very crucial. Completion of syllabus is very, very crucial. You can't skip even last chapters of portion. Like I am telling you about first mathematics, students tend to miss some easy chapters, right? That these are not much important. Data sets, mathematical reasoning, statistics. But from these three chapters or mathematical induction, right? So from these four chapters, approximately two questions are asked every year, every paper, every sitting, right? So you can't skip those chapters also. And these chapters are very, very easy. Means if you give only 2 days of time, you can get approximately 8 marks from this only. So try to cover up all the syllabus. Expertise in chapters is not necessary for JE Mains, because questions are not asked from too much depth, right? So you have to cover up all the syllabus and try to get understanding of all syllabus. Then come to previous year questions, right? Previous year questions are very, very important. You have to solve previous year questions approximately 40 years of JE Advanced and 15 to 20 years of JE Mains previous year question. While solving previous year question, you will put some their marking, like tick mark, star mark, brain mark, or like that, whatever is suitable for you to remember after some time, right? So like you have solved 100 questions and you have marked some 20 to 30 questions, before 2 to 3 months of examination, you have to solve only that questions. And you have to analyze question bank very effectively. That is very, very important. You can get there a very good understanding that how questions are actually asked in the examination, right? Now come to JE Advanced. Both the exams syllabus are approximately same. JE Advanced syllabus is a little bit small, but here depth is very important. Questions asked are actually experiment-based question, right? Real-life problems, you can say. So concept is important. Concept is very, very important here. So here you, if you have skipped some questions, then it is not so big issue. Like in some chapters, you have a good depth of concept, and some here you doesn't have good concept, good depth in some chapters. So it is not an issue, because you don't have to solve each and every question. Even you even don't need to attempt every question, right? If you have solved some 50% question, then you can get a good rank. And if you have solved correctly 60% question, then you can get very good rank. So try to have a good understanding of that syllabus. Also, there is a pattern wise difference. In JEE Mains, you will see there is only types of questions. One is a single choice correct option and a numerical based question. Numerical based question is introduced in 2 to 3 years back. And in JEE Advanced, you will see many types of different types of questions, right? A single correct question, multiple choice correct, multiple answer correct question, matrix matching type question, match the following type question, integer type question, numerical based type question, different types of question. There are different negative marking also in those questions. So in JEE Advanced, you can't get right solution from elimination process, right? In JEE Mains, you can get some of the questions, like 5 questions answered from elimination, like this option. This option will not be the can't be the answer of this question. Like this, you can eliminate 3 of the options and you can get the right answer. But in JEE Advanced, you have to actually get exactly the answer. So you have to actually get a very good understanding of that portion from where the question has been asked. Now, some coming to general solutions, some general concepts. Concepts are very important. Key notes for quick revision is very, very important, right? I have made a mistake in JEE Mains first attempt that I have not prepared key notes. So you should make key note. That is very, very important for quick revision. Take proper sleep before examination. Don't panic during the examination. Eat light food. During the examination, calculate properly and read the question carefully, and also mark the option carefully, right? So if you have solved, you have given the crucial 2 to 3 minutes of the examination, and you don't read the question carefully, or you don't read the options carefully, you can lose even -1 marks. So you lose approximately 5 marks of you, and 5 marks is very, very important in these types of competitive examinations. So please mark the options carefully, because options are very confusing, you know, if you have seen any previous year question or questions. Don't stuck in any question. Don't lose confidence in between. Like you can't able to solve approximately 5 to 6 questions in a chain, and you should not lose hope at that point. Even with my side also, I think JEE Mains, I couldn't solve some 5 to 6 questions in a row, right? Then I can solve approximately 2 to 3 questions in a row, and then approximately 5 to 6 questions in a row. So you should not lose hope in between the examination, right? Then you should mark the time taking questions during the examination, and after you have time to solve, then only you should solve the question, right? You know, don't go over gut feeling that I can solve this question. I have read very well this topic. I can solve this question. There are some questions that are even intentionally to lose some time, right? So don't get into trap of that questions. You can give some mock tests, 5 mock tests approximately, to get an idea, more deep idea about how to tackle these situations in the actual examination. In subject-specific expertise area, I would like to say that in math, all topics are actually important, but in maths, calculus and algebra is very, very important. That is, very much questions are asked from these chapters. In JEE Advanced, Koenig section is also very important. Some good questions are asked from these chapters. In chemistry, approximately all topics are important, but try to get a good understanding. In chemistry and physics, I would like to say some both common things like modern physics and THDM, thermodynamics. These two chapters are common in both the subjects, chemistry and physics, and very good number of questions are asked from both the chapters. Try to cover up these chapters very well. So there is some disturbance. But I think there is some disturbance. Okay, sir.
Now it is okay.
My last advice is to don't skip the class. Right? Ever try to don't skip class ever. Coming to my suggestions over books for preparation, Maths, G. Tiwani, Singh publication is good for J.E. Mains and J.E. Advanced both. New Pattern, J.E. Problems from S.K. Goel is also a very good book. In chemistry, for all subjects, previous year question bank is must. That is one book, right? So after that, in chemistry, NCERT is must. That is 100% must. If you are missing that, then you are losing a much, right? Then for organic chemistry, you can solve questions from MS Chauhan. There are very much questions from that. You can if you have not time, then it is okay to skip some of the questions. In physical chemistry, you can solve R.C. Mukherjee. In this also, you can solve some of the questions because questions are very much in number. In physics, Singh's publication, B.M. Sarma book is very, very good. You can solve that. Or D.C. Pandey is also good. But for J.E. Advanced, I will suggest B.M. Sarma, Singh's publication. Okay, thank you, everyone. If you have any questions, feel free to ask a question in chat box. And try to focus on your positives. Right. You have, all of you have some positives and some negatives. Try to focus on your positives and try to decrease the negative ones. You will definitely crack the examination. Over to you. Sir, I think your voice is breaking.
Sir, am I audible? Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
Right. Am I audible to you,
Rahul? Yes, sir, say again.
Right. Before we take up the question from the student, we would like to hear to Mr. Karun Gupta and Mr. Vishnu, right? And then we will take up the question.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Right? Okay. Yeah, now, Abhijit, we can make a request to
right, sir. So now I will request Mr. Karan Gupta to share his views and thoughts for IIT JEE preparation. Over to Mr. Karan Gupta.
Hello, good morning, everyone. It's my pleasure to be here. So as my friend Rahul said about the preparation of IIT JEE, I won't say about the exam, but how to prepare exactly for IIT JEE. Means, first of all, I would like to say that how to study a chapter. First of all, in my suggestion, what I personally did, first you should see before a chapter is being taught by a teacher, first you should see the book and see the topics which you are going to study and try to make a brief roadmap of that chapter in your mind. And then after that, you can study from your teachers or you can see videos on YouTube or whatever to learn it. And when you study it from teachers, then you should go
through. I think there is a network issues with Mr. Karan Gupta. We are facing some technical glitches. Mr. Karan, your voice is not audible. Can you say something? Mr. Karan Gupta, am I audible, sir?
Hello, I think now I would be audible.
Yeah. Please. Audible.
Sorry for the disturbance.
I
was speaking to how exactly to prepare for a chapter. So after studying the chapter from teachers or videos, then you once again go through the whole chapter in the book. Means study nicely through the book and try to make a very short note. Means not large notes, very short note. Means one chapter you can prepare in 4 to 5 pages and write the formulas nicely and so prepare like that. And also I would like to give a tip that you are not particularly preparing for an exam. You are studying for being a knowledgeable person and do something for the society by using your knowledge. So it is, so science is very interesting. So try to understand the concepts like that. You are watching a movie and it's very interesting. So try to take everything as you are going to learn something from it, not particularly for exam. And there is one more tip for me that my friend Rahul and Krishna, we always did that thing. We made a group and we usually solved 4 to 5 questions daily from each subject. And then we tried to discuss together whatever Rahul solved, whatever Krishna solved. They told me and I told what I solved, and then means we had a lot of experience of many questions. So you can also make small groups and study like that. And then in this subject, the feeling of the concept is very important. Means you could that your preparation for IIT should be like that you can feel the concept. Means for example, you are studying kinematics, so you should feel that how it is actually taking place. You shouldn't just remember everything. You should try to understand concepts nicely. So that would be very good, and you can easily recap in exam. And at last, I would also say that please make very short formulas from each chapter. There are mainly 5 to 10, 20 formulas. So try to make a formula copy and try to write those formulas in it. And then this exam is nothing very difficult exam. This is also an easy exam, but you have to study all chapters nicely. Means you should always try to discuss all those chapters with your friends, and this in your daily livelihoods, this chapter should come. While talking, you should always talk about this chapter, about those concepts, and try to normalize everything. Okay, so with this I would like to end my speech, so I can pass to the moderator.
Yes, sir. So may I request now Mr. Krishna Prakash to say his view?
Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. You're audible.
Okay. So my name is Krishna Prakash. I am from Hazaribagh and I have studied from St. Xavier School, Hazaribagh. I did preparation of IIT from Achievers Classes, Hazaribagh, and now I am studying in IIT Kharagpur. I am studying the architecture and regional planning. So I would like to say about the point that sir also said, that is it really hard to study for boards as well as prepare for IIT at the same time? So it's not. We can study for both IIT as well as boards. Like I scored very good in boards. I got 95.6% and I cleared IIT in first attempt. So it's a misconception that if we study for IIT, then our board marks would be better. Because when we study for things of the IIT, it's almost the same thing that I'm in the books. We have to just study hard and be one more thing I'd like to add. If you study for a few days or a week or a month, that will not give you the result. You have to study hard and be sincere for like about 2 years, and you have to be you have to study really hard not to get in the other things like social media and all things, which can cause you a disturbance. And
Mr. Krishna Prakash, your voice is not audible.
One more thing is said by and
there is a network problem, network issue with Mr. Krishna Prakash. Yes, Mr. Krishna Prakash is facing some technical problem. I hope he is visible on my screen but not audible. Mr. Krishna, your mic is off, your camera is off. Please turn it on. No, sir, he left. I think he's facing some technical problem. So your voice is not audible, sir.
Am I audible now?
Yeah, you're audible now, sir. Right, so students, while Mr. Krishna Prakash joins with us, you have any questions, you can just type in the chat box. Meanwhile, you can...
I hope that he has come back.
He is joining back, sir. Sir, I think he is facing some network issues, sir, over there. Continuously, I am giving the permission to join, but
well, my time is not there. We can proceed further with the question answer session. Before we take up the questions from the students, who are mentioned in the chat box or those who will be mentioned further also, in fact, I would like to draw their attention towards some of the very important points that are identified as well. I don't think that's not the problem. I mean, one thing to care for, I say, don't start thinking of it as a class 12 or most of the month of class 12 are in tablet. You need to start thinking about that from now on. When you're making a decision in class 11, you have to start thinking about that. That's one thing is a member of the exercise. That's to see the guidelines that what you should approach to study in the chapter. As in their presentation, in the presentation of the current book and the presentation of the Rahul Agarwal also, enough guidelines have been given regarding the presentation of the chapter, that these are both chapters on which the students will be more attention. Am I audible, Mr. Vijay?
I think, sir, little more voice breaking is there, sir. Yeah, Mr. Krishna Prakash has joined back, sir.
That's right. That's fine. Let's put it further.
Okay. Just a moment, sir. I'll. Yes, Mr. Krishna Prakash, you can just unmute yourself.
Yeah. Am I audible now?
Yeah, you're audible now.
Okay. So like I was saying that we should be regular in studying and we should
Mr. Krishna, you're not audible again.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, you're audible now.
Hello.
Yes, you're audible, sir.
I can't hear anything. Hello.
Okay. We are able to listen to you.
Sir, the voice is breaking.
Yes, sir, I'm here, sir.
I think I will change my connection. Wait a minute.
I can see on my screen, but his voice is not audible and his camera is also off. Your voice is also having some technical issues, sir.
You can pick up the questions that is mentioned by the students in the chat box.
I think due to the bad weather, there is a technical glitch.
Okay, sir, you are saying that we can take questions.
Right. So students, you can just... Okay, so we have a first question from Ranjit, and I would request our resource person. The question is, the role of teachers in understanding the concept of chapters.
Hello?
Yes, Mr. Karan.
Yeah, so teachers definitely have a huge role in teaching you any concept. So if in class, if you are not able to understand any concept, then again try to ask the teacher. Because teachers are also very friendly. In my school, I always try to interact with teachers. They explain every concept very well. You can ask them after the class. Don't disturb them in class only because they have limited time in class. But you can ask them afterwards and they can explain you the concept very nicely. And even after, if you are not able to understand from the teacher, then you can search that topic in YouTube. And in YouTube, there you can find many videos. And if you will see 3-4 videos, then it's 100% that you will understand that thing very well.
So Mr. Krishna Prakash has joined back. Sir, you can unmute yourself.
Yes. Now is it fine?
Yeah, now it is perfectly all right.
Okay.
So we'll pick up the questions after Mr. Krishna Prakash finishes off with his presentation. So over to you, Mr. Krishna Prakash.
Okay, so it is one more thing is that many students find difficulty, like when they enter the 12th class, they think that how to study about the 11th things because they think that there is less time. So about that, I would like to say that it's not necessary that you give too much time on the 11th things also. You study for the things and the chapters, new chapters which come up in the 12th class, and give like almost half an hour to 1 hour every day to the 11th class subjects and all the topics. In this way, you would be able to cover all the things quite properly. And you should give the mock test regularly, like every month you should give. This will give a reality check, like how are you performing and which are the areas in which you have to cover, because there will be questions which you won't be able to solve, and then you would know that in this chapter I have to work more hard and do things more properly. And one more thing, my friend Karan said that group study and is very important, because you also get the idea that how others solve. Maybe that you solve a particular question in one way, like in maths or physics, and the other person has different idea which could solve, which would be able to solve in very less time. So that will be really good for all you. And yeah, that's all. Thank you. And yeah.
There was a first question from Harsh K. When you were preparing for JEE, how much satisfaction did you get from your hard work? I think your question is after getting the result, how much satisfaction did you get? See, one thing is there, you should not have any type of regret after the examination that I could have get better than this. If I had done this thing or I had done, not done this thing, then I could have gotten. This regret should not come in any way after the examination. So when you are playing, try to think about this, that you should not have this type of regret. When you are chatting in WhatsApp or Facebook or Instagram, you should have this thing in your mind. And my suggestion is you should not have these accounts now. After 12, there are much time to do these things, means Facebook or Instagram or Twitter like this. Like for online things, you can use WhatsApp. that is generally necessary, but you can use notification off the notifications option. You can off the notifications of WhatsApp and see all the messages or and all the important messages on a particular time in a day, right? So the question from my side is, yes, I was satisfied that I what I had studied and what I had prepared, I achieved that thing. Next question, I think there was a
question from Harsh itself. How to skip time-taking questions?
Yes, sir. I have said about skip time-taking questions, right? So how to skip time-taking questions? When you will solve some 50 to 60 to 100 questions of a particular chapter, you will get a very good understanding that this type of question, I have to do these calculations in this question, right? When you are studying, when you are reading a question, you an image is getting made in your mind that I have to calculate these things. I have to use this formula and I have to calculate this and I will get the result this thing, right? So after solving those questions, 50 to 60 questions of that level, you have a very good understanding of a particular question. So you will be able to find out time-taking question and some easy questions, right? And for time-taking questions in particularly JEE mains, you will find some elimination techniques, right? You can use a dimensional analysis for some question. Dimensional analysis means you have written, I think, first or second chapter in 11th class of physics, right? So with that, you can get some questions answered, like 1 to 2 questions in whole paper. You can get answer directly from dimensional analysis. Those are questions that are lengthy, but you can get intentionally that are given to you to quickly solve from dimensional analysis or some your quick in that time, how you tackle in that situation. It's upon to you and your mind.
Right. The next question, revise class 11.
What, sir?
The next question is when and how to revise class 11?
Sir, I think that question Krishna Prakash has answered already.
Okay. So there was a question from Rohit Kumar. How many hours to study a day for achieving JEE mains?
See, there is not a fixed boundary that this is a boundary. This is exactly 5 hour or 6 hour or 7 hour. You will read and you will study at that time. This is all about concentration. How much concentration you pay onto your study, right? If you are paying much attention to your classes and some attention to your self-study, then you can crack the examination very easily, right? And even if you are studying like 12 hours and you are not paying much attention, then you will not be able, literally you will not be able to crack these examinations. You have to pay attention, right? So there is not a fixed boundary. When you are feeling that now this from this chapter in 50 questions, I am solving 40 questions, 40 questions approximately. You can think that from this, if questions are came, I can solve from JEE mains. And JEE advanced, literally you can't be ever sure that you will solve in that particular chapter. You can solve every question, right? You can solve 70 to 80% to 90% if you have prepared very well, but you can't even ever solve because questions are set from a very deep thinking. Some questions are asking very deep thinking. So try to only get some deep understanding of that chapter, try to practice and that's all.
So next question we have from Ranjit. How to cover backlog?
Yes. Okay. I think this question I am taking, then Karan Gupta will take the rest of questions.
Okay.
How to cover backlog? This is very important. You should not have a pile of backlog, right? If you have write some topics, so try to complete it very soon, right? Try to complete it very soon. And whenever you completed it, try to make a keynote of that. So you can revise it that. This is very important. Backlog includes your keynotes. Keynotes is an integral part of your studying, Right. So covering backlog, how to cover backlog is upon you, how to cover it. But it is important to cover it. Now over to Karan.
So we'll take the next question from Mr. Karan Gupta. Question we have, what do you think about solving single book properly instead of solving multiple books? It was from Sumit. A very interesting question.
You should not focus solving many books. You should always try to follow one book. And also you should try to read the concepts from that book only, and also solve not all the questions from that book, because you won't have that much time to solve the all questions. So in every book, there is a section of hot questions. So try to solve those questions and then try to solve the long questions too. And for the very short questions, you shouldn't write it, but you should directly see the question and try to make it in your mind that can you solve that or not, and only focus on one book because you won't have time to solve many books.
So the next question is from Krishna. He is asking about, would it be right to take a draw for the preparation for JEE mains? Because it is a very common question. We should go for a draw. So Mr. Karan.
Yeah, definitely it depends upon your interest. For example, if you want to do civil services or some preparation of some general government exam competition, then you shouldn't take the draw. But if you are interested in science, if you are interested towards science, you are very fascinated towards doing anything electrical, electronics, computer science, so you should definitely opt for the drop. And because if you even fail, then also you can get some low grade colleges like BIT Sindri is there. You can set up a goal that I can bring approx 92% percentile, 93% percentile, then I can get that college. Even if you not go in IIT, then you can go in some government institute only, like BIT Sindri. So you can take drop if you are really interested in science.
You should now focus to crack it in appearing only, right? You should not keep it in mind that I have one extra year, I can drop like this thing. You should now try to only crack it in appearing, right?
Yeah, that is
not
a very
think good. About dropping.
Yeah, that is a very good suggestion for the students. So before taking up the next question, we have a hand raise from Vince. I'll ask to unmute a particular student. Student, you can unmute yourself. Introduce yourself.
Sir, I have a question. Which is better, NDA or IIT?
Definitely in NDA, it is very less probable that you can crack the SSB exam, and there is only one attempt and it is very limited. So it is better to go for IITs and NITs because excluding the bottom 3-4 IITs, all rest IITs are very good. And also in NITs, the top 4 IITs are really comparable to the IITs. And also the below NITs are also very good. And there are many government funded institutes also. So they are really good. And here you can easily take some good placement if you work hard in engineering college. So in my view, if you are inclined towards science, then you could opt, you can take IIT JEE field only, because NDA is not, you have to crack SSB in NDA, which is quite very much tough.
Yes, so the next question. Mr.
Your inputs. I would like to say that it would really depend on you that which field you want to take and in what you are interested in. Should not be that someone forces you to do like IIT or NDA. It should be your decision at the final.
Yeah, it should be the call of the student to opt for the IIT or to opt for the NDA. So this was a very good answer. I think the student has got his answer. So the next question is, what number of questions are enough for one chapter, from Harsh Kumar? Mr. Karan, your input on this question. What number of questions are enough for one chapter?
See, it is you shouldn't see one chapter. One chapter includes of many topics, and you should go for the topic. And in that particular topic, you should see that 4-5 questions, and the examples given in the book are very important. Try to solve always the examples, and after solving the examples only go for other questions. And you can solve in a particular topic, you can solve 4-5 questions. And if you are then also not able to understand the topic nicely, then you could go for more questions. But you should study topic wise, not a chapter wise. Okay.
Yes, the next question we have from Sumit. Did you have a fixed target before the exam regarding rank or score? So I would ask this question to Mr. Krishna Prakash.
So for me, I did not have a very fixed score. I just wanted to score much better as I can. So that was my only goal.
So the next question from Ranjit. In this pandemic scenario, how to stay positive? Because we have started our critical phase of life in pandemic, as it was very difficult to shift from 10th to 11th. I would request Mr. Karan Gupta to give his input on this question.
Okay. So in this world, no one is going to care about your condition, that how your mental condition is now. So, and that exam won't ask about what condition you are going through. There are many students who are preparing very well and taking the use of the online generation. They are studying through YouTube and clearing their doubts, studying well. So try to get motivated that if you would not work, if you would not study, then you are not going to overtake those students. And finally, you are killing your life. There are many students who are studying very well. I have seen in this means also many students got very good in my circle also. Many students got very good rank. They did work hard. So you have to take motivation from them that if you won't work hard, then you are not going to get that successful. And how can you think to defeat a person who is now studying and you are simply wasting your time? So this could be your biggest motivation.
Right. So we are picking up the questions from the YouTube comment box also. So we have a question from the YouTube. Is it necessary to solve IRODOW for advanced? Mr. Rahul, your inputs on this.
Solving a foreign writer's book is not very important, right? I have told you some good books for preparing for JEE Mains and advanced both. You can solve any book, any good book, right? What I have told you, that was only my opinion and my suggestion that solve this. You can solve any book, and any book, any particular book is not necessary, right? In JEE Advanced, there is not any book written that this is suggested book from JEE Advanced side, right? So you can solve any good book that is covering that syllabus. It is upon you which book you are solving.
So the next question again from Mr. Rahul. Can we follow our passion as a backup besides preparing for the JEE? A very good question from Aditya Gupta.
Yes, you can follow your passions, right? Your passion could be singing, your passion could be playing some guitar, piano, or your passion could be playing cricket or anything. You should follow your passion and you should follow it happily, right? It will actually refresh your mind during studying. It is actually important also.
Okay, so the next question from Ranjit, I would take this question to Mr. Karan. How can we take advantage of this pandemic as whole day we are at home only? A very interesting question.
See, I have also this, I was also earlier facing problem, but in smartphone, you have got one focus mode in the smartphone. And nowadays in many mobiles, you are getting an option named parental and well-being control. If you will on that option, then you won't be able to access Instagram or those distracting apps throughout the day. and only when you will off that mode, then only you can means access those apps. So it is our usual habit that our fingers go on Instagram and Facebook automatically. So trying to on that settings can help you, and you could also track your how you spent the day in the apps. For example, you spent 4 hours on YouTube, 2 hours on WhatsApp. So you can track, and from the next day, you should develop some control on you that I would not use that app for more than 30 minutes or 20 minutes. You can use these options.
Right. So the next question, I would take this question to Mr. Krishna Prakash. Which books should be followed in class 11 for the 3 subjects? I think physics, chemistry, and maths for theory as well as questions.
I think Rahul had answered this question. So I would like him to repeat the books, the name he said before. Rahul, right, can you repeat it?
Okay. I'm repeating. For maths, I will prefer G. Tiwani, Singage Publication book. It is a very, very good book for both, I think, theory and questions. A New Pattern, GE Problems from S.K. Goel. G. Tiwani book from Singage Publication and New Pattern, GE Problems from S.K. Goel. Both are comparable and you can solve either, right? No one is above anyone, right? Both are, you can say, parallel. You can solve either one, but not both. Besides this, you can solve, you should solve previous year questions. For chemistry, you must read NCERT line by line and thoroughly. After this, if you have time, then you can solve not all, but some questions of M.S. Chauhan, organic chemistry, or there is one more book, but M.S. Chauhan is a very good book, right? For organic chemistry, M.S. Chauhan. For physical chemistry, you can solve R.C. Mukherjee. Writer's name is R.C. Mukherjee. Right? You can solve from this book some questions from each topics. Then coming to physics, for inorganic chemistry, I think NCERT is, I think it's enough, right? For physics, you can solve and read from B.M. Sharma, Singage Publication. It is a very good book. And if you can't solve that book, you can D.C. Pandey is also a very good book. So you can solve also that from that book. But I will prefer this, means B.M. Sharma. I will prefer this.
Right. So I think Shreya has got the answer. We have a question from YouTube. There is student Rohit Kumar. He wants to take a drop in this time. Where he should go for preparing, offline or online mode? It's a very good question, because this pandemic is creating a tough situation for even the students also. So what should they do? Mr. Rahul, your input on this.
So I think you are from class 12th, means you are passing this year. I think this question is from you, right? So from your perspective, if you have not studied very well, so you are feeling that you can't crack this time. So it's okay that you are dropping. For online and offline mode, I think from in this pandemic mode, you can't get to any offline mode, I think, because our colleges are also not opening from previous 1 year. So I think there is no hope after 6 months, they will open in offline mode. So it's okay that you are preparing in online mode. No problem. There is a direct message to me. Sir, watching lectures with high concentration or reading books, which one is more beneficial, as I don't like reading books? See, watching lectures, if you are getting enough knowledge of the chapter and all the topics, then you can go through only watching lectures and then solving some questions from books, right? It's okay that if you don't like reading books, means theory from books, but you have to solve questions. That's a must.
Next question we have from Tanisha Sood, a YouTube viewer. How did you manage physics? Like, it is always a turning point for marks. Yeah, this is a good point. How did you manage solving numericals and all concept based questions? So Mr. Karan, I would like to give your inputs on this question.
Yeah, I was quite good in physics. You could definitely try to at first focus on the topic. Please don't think on the question. In physics, understanding the concept very well. I am speaking it as very well. You should understand, you have a crystal clear knowledge of the theory. And after hearing the theory in physics, then you can see the examples given in the book. And after seeing the examples in the book, you can solve a few questions. But the must is that you should understand the topic very well. If you haven't understood a topic in physics, then you solve 100 questions also, then also it won't be helpful for you. So try to clear that topic from YouTube, from teachers, or from anywhere. But try to do the topic very well. It is the most important thing in physics. And then only you can solve the examples, and then you can solve some hard question or the questions given in book.
Right. So I think Tanisha has got the answer. Next question we have from Sasi Sharma. Are NCERT books really helpful?
Yeah. In maths, they are not very helpful. And in physics also, they are not very helpful. But in chemistry, they are the most prioritized book, because in chemistry, almost 90% of the questions are from the chemistry NCERT book only. So you should, be it anyone, that earlier one boy asked that should we read the book. So in chemistry NCERT, you should definitely read it. You are not going to benefit from anywhere other else more than NCERT. So it is very, very important in chemistry. Remember that. And in physics also, you can study that magnetic, there was one chapter about magnets, and the last chapters of modern physics, you can study from NCERT, because those are short chapters, and usually teachers don't get that much time to go that far in the syllabus. So in modern physics, you should study from NCERT in physics. And math, you can leave that NCERT, but you should solve the NCERT exemplar. NCERT exemplar have very good questions. So you should definitely solve that.
So right. So the next question, I would take it to Mr. Krishna Prakash. The question from Pushkar Shukla. Is timetable really important for preparation, Mr. Krishna Prakash?
Okay, so timetable really depends on the students. Like, if you are good at following the timetables and you can like follow it sincerely for like about a year, then you should surely go for the timetable. Like for me, I did not make a timetable because I could not follow the timetable. Like if you fix that, I would study or 1 hour, 2 hour only maths, and then turat shift kar jana hai fir Hindi, shift kar jana hai fir turat physics mein. So like I would not able to do that. So like for me, I would study that what I wished for at that particular time. But it is that whatever you study, you should give your full heart and full concentration into studying, whether it's timetable or it's not.
So the next question I would take, sir.
Mr. Vijay, we can take input regarding this question from the rest too also, because this happens
yes,
to
sir.
Be a very important question.
Yes, sir. Right. Yes, sir. The same, sir. So I would request Mr. Rahul and Mr. Karan to say their view.
Yes, timetable, if you are making a timetable and you are following that is, I think, very important, right? You have a huge topics. There are some more, like you are backing, you have some backlogs also that you are not able to complete at exactly that time. So having a timetable in your mind is a good thing in preparation for JEE mains and JEE advanced and any competitive examination. It is a good thing that having a timetable.
Mr. Karan.
Yeah. Timetable really helps, because if you don't make timetable, then you will sometimes you will just waste randomly your time that what should I study. But in my view, you should not make a very long timetable. You should just plan your next day the night before. Means today night I will prepare, I will think in my mind that what I am going to read and what I am completing tomorrow. So this should be the strategy.
So the next question we have from Sivan Spreet, what are the other career options except engineering? Mr. Karan.
Yeah, this question is really unique. There are many, many options except engineering. I don't know many options, but as I have seen, many options are there. Like you can follow your passion, or NDA is the option, and NIFT is the option. NIFT, I would like to talk that NIFT is a very good option for the science students who have maths as their subject. So they can. So NIFT is a very good option. NIFT is also institute like an IIT only, and they give quite high packages that people interested in fashion designing and craft, art and craft, you can definitely choose that way. You don't need to be very smart in science. You just need to be a bit smart in art and crafts. That's it. And you can see this question from YouTube also. You can search.
So, Mr. Rahul, your inputs on this question.
There are infinitely many career options you have, right? Each student, you have positives over you, right? Each student have different positives. So you can go in any field you want, right? Any field means if you are, if you can sing good, you can go in singing. If you can play something very well, then you can go in that field. Cricket is not a very good option, but it is also an option. Like that, I am saying not a good option because I think in India, in especially in Jharkhand, Bihar, every person plays cricket, right? And in national cricket team, only I think so 15 players are good players that get some good salary, or you can say 30 to 50. So there is a very less probability in that field, but you can go in any field you want. There are infinitely many field. There is only a field of engineering, and you should not go in field of engineering with force of anyone, like force of your parents, force of your relatives, force of your teachers. You should choose it.
The next question I'm picking up from the YouTube, the question is, are the institute module enough material to crack the advanced exams? I'll take the input from all three of you. Mr. Rahul.
Yeah.
Mr.
Karan. Yeah. Institute modules are really very good. If you are following one institute module nicely, then you don't need to even read the books. You can read, but questions are definitely more than enough. And the concept is also quite enough, but you can see some more books also for concept, but questions are definitely more than enough in the institute module. You can definitely crack advanced through that.
Mr. Rahul.
So which institute he is talking, I don't know actually. So which module he is talking, I don't know. And what content is it covering? So if you you can see it, means you can see it by your own mind that these things you have to cover, these things are in the syllabus of JEE Advanced. This module is covering or not? If the module is covering, then it's okay to follow that. And if it is not covering, then you have to go or you have to pay some extra effort to cover that thing.
Next question we have from Krishna. If class 11 is not that good, then how much it will affect him in class 12 for IIT JEE preparation exams? I think this is the question he want to ask. He has written half question.
This
is not good.
Yeah. Many students have asked me this question. So I have particularly told them you shouldn't read the whole class 11 because you won't have that time. But you can focus on studying few chapters, and that you can ask from your teachers. That in for example, in maths, I could say that you can study Sheth's chapter, relation and function, then trigonometric functions. You should study those chapters, and now you can ask your teachers very well that what should I read in 11 so that I won't have any problem in 12th. So you can ask your teachers this question, and they will name you the particular chapters so that you don't have any problem in 12th. So teachers should also keep this in mind that they should tell this.
Yeah, the question regarding this the institute module which was asked, actually the student was asking regarding the resonance, the institute modules which are provided.
I think it's fine.
Yeah, I have also seen that in the resonance module, the concept even is also enough in resonance, and the questions are also enough. So you don't even need to go to other book. So more than enough.
Yeah, we have a question from Sasi Sharma. What will happen if I don't crack IIT or get admission in any government college?
Don't be that much negative, but their life doesn't stop at any point, so you should try to move on. You can, if you have your financial conditions are good, then you can opt for a private institute, or you can even go to DU or try to prepare try to study physics, chemistry, maths from DU, and also then you can go to ISRO, DRDO through research options. There are many ways, so life doesn't stop at any point. Don't worry from that.
The next question, I'll take it to Mr. Rahul. How to know our passion? The student is asking, Shivansh Preet.
It's a good question. How to know your passion, right? You don't know your passion, right? So actually you have to find your passion by yourself. Like if you are studying, first thing you have to study in any field, right? Besides studying, there are fields, but there is a lot of competition. Like you see, in cricket, there are only 11 seats in all over India with different ages, right? In IITJ, every year, there are approximately, I think so, 13,000 seats, right? I think Virat Kohli is playing from last 10 years. So there is a one seat in cricket, in top 11, that is fixed from last 10 years, right? But in JEE Advanced, every year, 13,000 seats are vacant. In NIT, there are, I think so, more than that, 30,000 approximately seat, I don't know. So in study in this field, like in medical field or in engineering field or any field, there are much, much more seats. Than you can say music field, cricket field, or any other field. So how to know your passion? You have to find your passion. Like you know that you can sing well, or you can't even sing well, but you want to sing. That is your passion. You want to code. So coding is your passion. You want to solve means a Rubik's cube maybe or something like that. So you have to find out your passion.
Yes, the next question from hers is, his ambition is to become an IAS, but before that I thought of clearing IIT. So would that be okay if he take a drop? If he's unsuccessful in clearing in my appearing years? Mr. Karan.
Yeah, means you should analyze your condition. If you think that you are very close to cracking IIT or JEE Mains, then you should definitely take a drop and then you can prepare for IAS, because almost 75% of IAS are engineers only. So even if you fail in the appearing year, then you can see that how close were you to clearing that exam. And if you think that I can clear the next time, or even if I can get good rank in JEE Mains also, then you can opt to drop, because 1 year doesn't matter so much. You can drop.
So the next question is from all three of you. If the student is Manish Kumar is asking a question, if he cracks JEE Mains but fails in JEE Advanced, what are his career options after JEE Mains? So I'll take one by one from all three of you. Yeah, Mr. Krishna.
Sir, so JEE Advanced is basically for the admission in the IITs. So if you fail JEE Advanced, to clear JEE Advanced, you won't get IIT, but on the basis of the score of the JEE Mains, you can get into NITs. And the other government college, you can get admission through JEE Mains.
I think the answer would be the same from Rahul and Mr. Karan.
Yes.
So yes, students, if you have any query, again, I'm asking, you can raise your hand or you can just use the chat box.
So there is a direct message to me. Sir, how to command ourselves in solving question if we are unable to solve question. Right. So if you are having a particular depth of a particular topic, right? So you can solve some questions, right? After solving, you can get an idea to how to tackle some particular question. In some JEE Advanced problems, you will face some type of difficulty in cracking the problem. This is like you can say a ball, and there in a ball there is a hole, right? You have to find that hole to get into that ball. Like, it is, some questions are like that. So these questions are something difficult, right? If you have find that hole in first go or second go, you will crack that question very easily. You will find the answer of that question very easily. But if you are unable to solve that question, and if you are unable to find that hole in one or two go, that question will be very, very difficult to you. Questions are set in that way, right? So if you are command means what? You can practice more. If you are having not so much information about that topic, you should collect some more information and then you can go for the questions.
So I have a question on behalf of students. How many times a student can appear for JEE Mains exam?
For JEE Mains, you can appear 3 times, I think so. And for JEE Advanced, you can appear 2 times. That I think. But exact information, you can Google it.
Yeah, that's correct. That's correct.
So students, if you have more questions, you can send us your questions. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay, before we take up any more question from a student, I would like to ask a question to any one of them, if they can answer. Like, what was that point of time when you thought of preparing for IIT? Like, it happens that when we take admission to 10+2 and when we start thinking of our career, well, it is said that once we clear our board examination of 10th board, we must think of selecting our subject, keeping this in our mind that what exactly we want to achieve in our life. See, it's not there that somebody said to us that you go for commerce, we go for commerce. Somebody says to us to go for science, we go for science. It's there that there are many avenues that students should look for, and accordingly as what suits them the most, they should go for. But then three of you opted for science, and then what was the point of time that when you thought of preparing for IIT? Was it from the very beginning, or it happened at later stage? Or was it the time in your life also when you switched from one option to another option? You had certain other career option and then you switched to another career option. How did it happen with you exactly? Please.
From beginning only, I was very much interested in science and mathematics. So when I asked people, then they told me that IITs are the best institute for the technological purpose. And if you are good at science, then I had a thought from 9th, 10th class only that I will start preparing for it, or I will prepare as nicely the chapters, because IIT JE is not different from what you study in boards. That's just a bit increased depth of the knowledge, but that's all, the syllabus is almost same. So even while going to school, I knew that I have to study the concept very well. So I did like that, and when I saw that I am now in good position that I can solve those questions of IIT also, then I started solving those questions. And then the life moved, and then the position came.
That's excellent. Yeah, please, to the next one.
For me also, I was interested in science and mathematics. Actually, I wanted to become a scientist in a class 8, from class 8. So I have a definite path that I will take science stream and will try to crack the advanced.
Okay. And Mr. Krishna?
So for me, I did know about IIT or NIT up to class 10th. In class 10th, I came to know about it because like I was interested in science and mathematics. And then I proceeded towards taking maths in class 11th. And then
That's great. The thing is that when you make a choice of achieving something in your life, then students need to be serious with that. The nutshell is that once you decide to achieve something, after you decide, you are determined, then you have to be serious with your approach. That is what I could understand listening to all of you. Yeah, fine. Now, Abhijit, over to you.
Yeah, the next question from Sivan Spreet. After studying the topic, he is able to solve the questions, but after some days, he fall to solve it. He forgets to solve it. What to do? I think this question is related to everyone.
Yeah, definitely. I think that he must not be understanding the concept very well. You would understand the concept very well, then I think that problem won't occur. But even if you fail to solve that question, then you can make a note of it in the copy. And in what particular point you missed that question. So you should definitely mention those things in your notebook that can help afterwards, and try to solve a question or if you solve one time, then try to see it after 2 to 3 days, then you can remember. But remember the main thing, that you are not here to remember a question. You are here to understand a concept, because that question is not going to come in the exam. That concept will come. So try to focus on concept nicely.
Yes, so students, this question, like related to this question, we have a very common term, we call it STM, short term memory. Basically, students generally ask these questions in every counseling session to what to do. So, but students, as you know, okay, whenever there is a session, all the resource persons come up with very basic knowledge. Like, you have to understand the concept, not the question. This is a very good answer which was given by Mr. Karan. And everyone gives the same answer. You have to understand the concept. So this was the question, very good question. And I think, Sivan, you got the answer for this. Okay, so many more questions from the students we have. If we have, hurry up. We are about to enter.
As we are approaching the end of the session, and no doubt it had been a very fruitful session where we could take up a number of questions from the students. Now, well, one more question has come from Harsh Kumar, but before we take up that question, I have another question for the resource persons present in this session. Well, in fact, when we talk about how to get success in life, it really attracts listening, like Mr. Krishna Prakash is there from IIT Kharagpur, then Mr. Karan Gupta is from NIT Rourkela, and then we have Mr. Rahul Agrawal from IIT Dhanbad. So it really attracts a lot, and we definitely look up to them, those who achieve a certain position in their life. But it is said that if you want to if you want to be a successful person, don't just see that they have become successful. Instead of that, try to read their failures in their life. It is said that before one gets success, a lot of failures are behind the scene, you know. And if you want to be successful in life, you do not see how they became successful exactly. You see how they overcome the failures in their life. If you understand this, that how they overcame the failures in their life, you will exactly be successful one day in your life, you know. So I'd like to make a request to all these three present here that would they like to highlight any remarkable failure of their life which they overcame, tried their best and they overcame, and that could definitely be an example for others?
Yeah, I would like to share mine, that you can see that I am in a top NIT. I could be in an IIT, but you can see that I am in NIT Rourkela, which is the second best NIT of India. So actually my rank in JEE Mains was quite good. It was the best in the almost Hazaribagh. So, but in JEE Advanced, my rank was not that good. So I would like to share why my rank in JEE Advanced was not good. Because I didn't prepare the mock test for the JEE Advanced nicely. I gave only one test and I didn't prepare only very well for the JEE Advanced. I thought that I can give the exam nicely, and even the first paper I gave very nicely. I had quite very good marks in the first paper, but in second paper I failed miserably. Means I couldn't balance my emotions in the second paper. Actually, means when I saw questions, then I felt that my time is running out. Then I got very hot tempered that time. That how the, now I can do that. But I remember that at that position, I should stop for 1 minute and I should stop solving all those questions and I should have relaxed for 1 minute and then I could have started doing the questions again. So that could have helped that time. So there can be many positions in your life that that will change your after future. So if any very any tense moment comes in your life, then you should stop for a minute and close your eyes and you should leave that work, and then you can again start that work after 1 or 2 minutes, because from 180 minute exam, 1-2 minutes will not matter much, rather than you are losing your whole exam. So this should be a strategy in life also, in any moment in the life.
That's great.
Yeah, so the next question before...
Can we listen to Mr. Rahul Agrawal and Mr.
Same thing.
Okay, I'm sharing. I have shared one of the experience, like I have not made keynotes. Keynotes is very, very important. You should make keynotes for quick revision before examinations. That is very, very important. I have failed to make and paid hefty price in JEE Mains. You should sleep properly before the night before examination. And you should read NCERT of chemistry very well. That is the most important thing in JEE Mains. NTS sets the set the question of the paper, and it sets like approximately 90% of the JEE Mains question are directly from the NCERT textbooks. In physics also, you can solve additional exercises are there in end of the exercises, you can solve that. So that are actually good question. There are some good questions. Do not panic during examination. Right. This is very important. And one more thing, you should not have a definite number of questions in your mind. Like I have to solve 50 questions in examination in 3 hours. If I could not able to solve 50 questions, I will fail or I can get very bad rank. That is very, very bad thing. It will overload your mind at the time of examination, and you can get some error in your calculation. So you should have a thing before examination, means before 1 month or 2 months, that I have to study this thing so I can get this type of this range of rank. But during examination, you should not have any rank or any number of question particularly in your mind.
Wonderful.
Mr. Krishna.
Yes. So for me in the year 2020, when the lockdown started, so I got a bit reckless and did not study much. The exams were postponed and I thought that I had more time to relax a bit. So that was the mistake I did, and it should not happen. You should always think that you should study every day, then only you would get the result. And one more thing that, like Karan said, similar thing happened to me in JEE Main 1. I started with the physics section and I was not able to solve a few of the starting 3 or 4 questions. And so that panicked me, and that led that very bad marks. And I made mistakes in very simple questions. So like, if you are not able to solve a few questions, like relax for 30 seconds, 1 minute, and then restart to solve the questions. Yeah.
So the best one.
That's great. And in fact, it is said that when you step forward towards your goal, it's not the final step that matters. It's that from the very beginning, your every step that counts. So it's there that how do we trade further cautiously and making sure that we don't waste our time. That is what I could understand listening to all these three. Yeah, Abhiji, proceed.
Sir, so one question from my side, Mr. Rahul, was that the campus of IIT ISM attracted you so much? Because I have been to IIT ISM 2-3 times, and it is a wonderful institute, I could say, for the people of Jharkhand we have.
So unfortunately, I could not get there even once, because campus has not opened since last, I think so, April or so. So classes are going online, and in third semester also classes are going online.
So the next question from Mr. Hers to...
Abhijit, we can pick up the last two questions and conclude
that, right? Yes, sir. From Hers, we have a question. The chemistry mastering the organic section would be very helpful. Is it true? In chemistry portion, the mastering the organic section would be very helpful. Is it true?
Yeah. In mastering the organic section is very important, because here you solve the questions quickly and you save a lot of time. And organic is not very tough if you study. If you don't miss any class of your teacher and follow the curriculum of organic nicely, and also make the notes of all the formulas, then you can easily score marks in JEE Mains as well as JEE Advanced, because organic isn't that tough. It is quite easy, and you are going to solve each question in 10 to 20 seconds. So you are saving a lot of time for other tough questions. So it should be your goal to complete organic nicely. It is very important.
So the last question, I think we are moving to, is from Pushkar Shukla. What was mode of your motivation for you, which is a must for every student, and what are your regards for that students who are fully demotivated and starts thinking that they are not capable of doing IIT? This is a very good question, and I would take the input from all three of you. So starting up with Mr. Rahul.
Mode of motivation. You have talked about mode of motivation. What is the mode of motivation for your study? You are studying, or what is the mode of motivation to join this session? Right. You have some motivation for every particular work you are doing. Right. You are eating, you have some mode of motivation. Maybe the mode of motivation that you have a hunger, you have hunger, so you are eating. You are sleeping, so you have a mode of motivation from your mind that your mind wants some relax time, so you are sleeping. So every time you have some motivation, right? When you are doing something and you know why you are doing that thing, then anything is not important for your motivation. You know why you are doing that thing. That is the motivation, and that is the only thing that can motivate you.
So the next part of this question, what are your regards for the students who are demotivated and start thinking they are not capable of doing it? Mr. Karan, your inputs on this question.
Yeah, if you are thinking that you are not capable of doing IIT, there is no worry. IIT is not everything. You can opt for NITs, not the top NITs, but you can opt for NIT Jamshedpur, the lower branches in NIT Jamshedpur. So your main goal should be to study as much as you can. Means you can't do everything, but you can do a bit, and you can do what you can do best from you. So try to give your best at that time, and now don't regret what you have done in past. Now try to cover what you all can. You can ask any senior that what chapter should I study to maximize my marks. Like that, you can prepare by making short goals that I will do tomorrow this thing, I will do tomorrow this thing, and then study nicely. That's on the only option.
Mr. Krishna, your inputs on this?
Yeah. And if you feel demotivated, then you should talk to your friends, teachers, and the parents. They will really guide you on how to do things. You should tell them what your problems are, where are the issue you are facing, and so they would really help you a lot and guide you thoroughly.
So this was the answers for the questions which was asked by students, and I think we don't have any questions right on the YouTube.
So a couple of direct messages to me. Sir, it is necessary to cover each and every topic, or just we can quit some. In JEE Mains particularly, you should cover every topic if you can. Right. In JEE Mains, I have said that I think from all over the syllabus, from every chapter's questions are asked. So if you are unable to cover up now every topic, if you have much of backlog, then it is okay. But if you are now studying from class 11, then you should cover up all the topics. That will, if you are not covering all the syllabus, then you can pay a hefty price of that. And the second question was that in comparison of three subject PCM, which subject is more scoring in examination, right? Which subject is more scoring, that is upon to you. For me, it's mathematics. I think for Karan Gupta, it is physics maybe, or Krishna Prakash, it's mathematics. So it's upon to you. Which subject is more interesting? Which subject is more interesting to you, and which subject you are feeling most easy? That is upon to you. But I think if you have enough knowledge about mathematics, then you can solve that very easily, because the question, the answer is only one for mathematics. Like you have solved and you have get an answer of 12.464. There is only one option. But chemistry is, if you have not too much deep concept, then it may confuse you in the examination time. And one question also is, are questions also necessary? Yes, theoretical questions are necessary, because in JEE Mains and JEE Advanced are necessary, because okay, Karan Gupta can take this question, or Krishna Prakash.
So there's a last question from Rohit. Are theoretical questions also necessary, Mr. Karan?
Yeah, definitely. Theoretical questions are very necessary, because theoretical questions test your knowledge of that concept. So if you are good at theoretical questions, then you would definitely make numericals more easily. So definitely theoretical, means you can't make questions if your theory is not clear. So theoretical questions are very necessary. In some questions you will ask why this happens, and means how. So you need to be theoretical very clear, and they are quite important.
So this was the questions from our students. Sir, with your permission, because we are running short of time now.
Yeah, that's Abhijit, that has been a wonderful session. And I must say that these all three resource persons today could do justice with the occasion, and many of the students could get the answers of their query, and that would certainly guide them.
to make up their mind for the future course of action. In fact, it was the time when a few days ago when I had a word with my friend, Mr. Arvind sir from Hazaribagh, and he gave me the name of these three meritorious students, and it all happened that today we are here in this session. So it has been a great time altogether. That's all about from my side. Abhijit, now we can conclude the session.
Right, sir. So before concluding the session, I would thank all our resource person, Mr. Rahul Agarwal, Mr. Karan Gupta, and Mr. Kishan Krishna Prakash, to spare the valuable times for our students, for motivating them so that in the coming future, they can opt for the IIT JEE mains in advance and crack it and become a successful person in their life. So from the entire school management, we convey our sincere regards and thanks to all three resource person. So with this, we come to the end of our the session. Thank you for joining. Thank you all,
sir,
of you.
It was a pleasure.
Yeah, it was our pleasure.
Thank you.
Yes,
so with this, we come to end of our session. So students, you can just leave the session now.